Looks like we're going to be doing... multiplication, you guys. Before we even get started, I'm just going to do a quick estimation because that will allow me to understand if my product, my answer, is reasonable. And when I look at the number 1,250, that number, if I would like to round it to the nearest thousands, I know that 1,250 is closer to 1,000 than it is to 2,000. So if I'm just looking to find out an estimation, I can multiply, bear with me here, 3 times 1,000. That would give me a product of 3, see if we can fit it in here, 3,000. So my answer, my product, when I am finished here, should be relatively close to 3,000 in order for me to determine if it's reasonable. All right, let's go ahead and let's get started. So we need to multiply 3 times 1,250. Okay, looking at that and thinking about expanded form and also thinking about the area model, what I see right here is that we have 4 places. We're in the thousands. So I'm going to go ahead and just draw my box, and I need to have 4 places. I'm going to be multiplying each place by the factor 3. So we've got 1,000. Remember how I had taught you guys that if you say the number slow enough, it kind of helps expand or stretch out that number to understand which each number represents or the value of each digit. Okay, 1,250. And as you can see, we don't have any ones. So I could put a 0 there just to hold my place. All right. That also means when we represent it like that using the area model, I'm going to go ahead and just kind of double dip here. And that also tells me that we are multiplying 3 times 1,000, 1, 2, 3, and comma. And then we would be adding up all of our partial products. So we've got 3 times 200 plus 3 times 50 plus 3 times 0 equals. Alrighty, let's go ahead and let's get started. We know 3 times 1 is 3, but that says 1,000. So 3 times 1,000 is 3,000. Then 3 times 200ths would be 600ths. If I write that down as a number, I'm going to go ahead and write it down as 600. Then I have 3 times 50, which is the same as 5 tens. And I know that 3 times 5, well, that's 15. But you guys, we didn't multiply just 3 times 5. We did 3 times 5 tens. So let's go ahead and let's add in our 0. And last but not least, 3 times 0 is... I couldn't trick you. Okay, it's 0. You're right. Now I've got all of my partial products that I need to add up. I'm going to go ahead and just write over here my addition sentence. I need to add up all my partial products. And you guys, I know that when I'm adding and subtracting, it's so important to make sure that my numbers are lined up using place value. 600. Then we've got 150, and I'm going to leave off my 0. We know that 0 was the 3 times 0. Starting in my ones column, just in case there could be a group of 10 hiding in there. 0 plus 0 plus 0, you nailed it. 5 tens plus 0 tens plus 0 tens is 5 tens. Amazing. 600 plus 100 is 700, and 3,000 plus no other thousands equals 3,000. It's a 1, 2, 3 and comma. I'm gonna go ahead and put my comma there. This tells me that my product is 3,750. Now, Remember, we estimated in the beginning. We said that 3 times 1,000 is 3,000, so that once we actually came up with our product, we would understand it's like a quick way to double check our thinking. Was my answer, my solution or product, reasonable? And I think that 3,750 is pretty close to 3,000, so that would absolutely be reasonable. How many toy animals does the shop order? The shop orders 3,750 toy animals. Now it's your turn to show what you know, either using this down here. We've got expanded form, and we've got our area model.